Hello everyone, I'm Divyashree. In this let us discuss about principles of communication system. Under this let us discuss the topic of envelope detector, switching modulator. Now switching modulator. So the circuit for the switching modulator, it is shown here. So this is the circuit for the switching modulator. Here we can see that it has a modulating signal, which means a message signal, and the carrier signal, that is C of T. Modulating signal will be baseband signal, it will be of low frequency, and carrier signal, which is of very high frequency compared to message signal. And this both are connected in series and given to a diode. Here diode act as a switch, and then we connected a load resistor RL, and the output is taken across this load resistor RL. Then the voltage at this point V1 of T equal to M of T plus C of T, that is M of T plus AC cos 2 pi FCT. Now I can say in this case, this is the idealized input-output relationship, that is V of T. We will get the output V of T, equal to 0 for all C of T is less than 0. If the value of the carrier signal is less than 0, then the output voltage will be 0, and if the carrier voltage is greater than 0, C of T is greater than 0, then we will get some output here. So that is shown in this. This plot is against V1 of T and V2 of T. So it will be having the linear relationship, slope equal to 1, V2 of T equal to V1 of T for all C of T greater than 0. So C of T is greater than 0, then what will be the value of V1 that will appear at the output? When the C of T is less than 0, then V2 of T will be 0, because the diode will be open circuit, so it will be, the output will be 0. So here we can see the modulating signal, that is M of T. Here we can see the carrier signal. It is a pulse signal is applied as the carrier, and the time period, it is T0 or T0 equal to 1 by FC. And this is the resultant wave, that is the A modulating wave, that is M of T into C of T is the resultant wave. Now what was the diode will be forward biased when the V1 of T is greater than 0. V1 of T means at the positive of the C of T, and it will be, so here see, it is the positive, C of T is positive, that is greater than 0, then M of T will appear at the output, V2 of T, we will get the M of T into C of T, that is this value into this, we will get like this. And next, here C of T is negative, so the diode will be reverse biased, we won't get any output, the circuit will be incomplete and open. Now at this point, again it is positive, so we will get M of T into C of T as the output. At this point it is negative, again we won't get any output. It continues till this, and after this, here M of T is positive, so M of T into C of T, that is a minus value into plus, that is minus value, we will get minus here. The same way, when C of T is negative, we won't get any output at that point. The diode will be open. And again, when it is positive, we will be getting the output. In this way, we will obtain the resultant wave. Now let us derive an expression for the V2 of t. So V1 of t equal to m of t plus c of t. That is, we know that c of t equal to ac cos 2 pi f c t. So m of t plus ac cos 2 pi f c t, and the value of m of t, mod m of t, is very much less than ac. This is the carrier high frequency, and this value will be, the amplitude will be very much large compared to m of t. The output of the diode, the output of the circuit, that is V2 of t, is defined as V1 of t when c of t is greater than 0, and V2 of t will be equal to 0 at the condition when c of t is less than 0. Mathematically, the output of the diode can be written as V2 of t equal to V1 of t into Gp of t, where we have used the carrier signal as a pulse strain. So I can represent Gp of t in terms of Gp of t. So V2 of t equal to, substituting for V1, m of t plus ac cos 2 pi f c t into Gp of t. Now, where Gp of t is a rectangular pulse strain with a period equal to t0 equal to 1 by fc. So representing Gp of t by its Fourier series, we have Gp of t equal to 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi summation n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 whole raised to n minus 1 divided by 2n minus 1 cos 2 pi fc into 2n minus 1 into t. So this is the given Gp of t, and from that I can rewrite as 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi cos 2 pi f c t plus odd harmonic components. So this will be the pulse strain, periodic plus pulse strain, t0 by 4, and the magnitude is 1. Now substituting the previous 4 in equation 3, so I can write V2 of t equal to m of t ac cos 2 plus ac cos 2 pi f c t into, substituting for Gp of t, that is 1 by 2 plus 2 by pi cos 2 pi f c t plus etc. So by multiplying 1 by 2 m of t, 2 m of t by pi cos 2 pi f c t ac cos 2 pi f c t by 2 plus 2 ac by pi cos square 2 pi fc, cos square theta equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So this, by using this relation, I can write V2 of t equal to m of t plus 2 m of t cos 2 pi fc t by pi ac by 2 cos 2 pi fc t plus 2 ac by pi, so 1 plus cos 2, in the making this in that form, 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So 1 plus cos 2 into 2 pi fct divided by 2. So again rewriting that, expanding that, I can write here 2 ac by 2 pi and 2 ac by 2 pi is there, cos 4 pi fct. So the final equation, m of t by 2, 2 m of t cos 2 pi fct, ac cos 2 pi fct, ac by pi, ac cos 4 pi fct. The output of the band pass filter. So once we get V2 of t, if we pass that through a band pass filter, then we will get the modulated signal. So if I pass that V2 of t through a band pass filter, then V2 dash of t equal to 2 by pi m of t cos 2 pi fct plus ac by 2 cos 2 pi fct. All other components gets filtered. So I can rewrite this by taking ac by 2 cos 2 pi fct common. So here 1 plus by 2 is there, so 2 into 2 divided by pi ac m of t. So this is in the form of AM signal. So And this one I can say ka into m of t. That is ka equal to 4 by pi ac amplitude, where ka is the amplitude sensitivity. So comparing to our aim equation, v2 dash will be same as the aim equation. This way we can derive the equation for v2 of t. Now let us look into a problem related to aim, that is m of t is given, e1 cos 2 pi f1 t, e2 cos 2 pi f2 t, e3 cos 2 pi f3 t volts, where e1 is greater than e2 greater than e3, f3 greater than f2 greater than f1. Give the time domain expression for the conventional aim, draw the amplitude spectrum of aim obtained in the part 1, also find the minimum transmission bandwidth. Solution: the time domain expression for the conventional aim is s of t equal to ac into 1 plus ka m of t cos 2 pi fct. This is the time domain conventional equation. Substituting the value of m of t, I can write this as ac into 1 plus ka e1 cos 2 pi fct, ka e2 cos 2 pi fct, ka e3 cos 2 pi fct into cos 2 pi fct. With respect to mu1 equal to ka e1, mu2 ka e2, mu3 ka e3. By using the trigonometric relations, taking the Fourier transform on both sides of the equation, we get s of f equal to ac by 2 del of, because it was the amplitude spectrum is shown below. As per the equation S of F, we plot this amplitude spectrum, and the maximum frequency is F3. F1, F2 and F3 was the frequencies. In that, F3 is the maximum frequency. Therefore, the transmission bandwidth is equal to 2F3. F3 plus FM, F3 minus FM, and total bandwidth in case of AM, it is 2FM. Here it is, maximum frequency is F3, so it is 2F3, and we had F minus FC plus F3 plus FC minus F3. This is FC, the carrier, this one here minus FC, then FC plus F minus FC plus F1, FC plus F1, FC plus F2, FC plus F3, FC minus F1, FC minus F2, FC minus F3. Minus FC plus F1 minus FC minus F1. That way we have plotted the spectrum for all the frequencies of F1, F2 and F3. So here we can see the envelope detector circuit. So it consists of a resistor and a envelope detector. Detector means demodulator. So at the end, the input to the circuit will be message signal, modulated signal, and the output will be our message signal. So it consists of a diode and a capacitor and resistor. Here we can see modulator signal, which is given as the input here, and then this is in the diode will be forward biased. In the positive half cycle, diode will be forward biased. So then negative half cycle, it will be clipped off. And here we can see that diode will be forward biased. When the diode is forward biased, this capacitor charges to the peak value. So in this condition, diode charges, capacitor charges to the peak value, to this. And then once it reaches the peak value, diode will be reverse biased and it will act as open circuit. So then the capacitor charges discharging through this path. So here we can see started discharging, and once it reaches here, that is fully discharged, then diode will be forward biased again and capacitor starts charging through this path. So here we can prove from here to here it charges again. Once it reaches peak, the process repeats like starts discharging, charging, discharging, charging, discharging occurs. In this way, we will get the envelope of the waveform. So this is called as envelope detector. Now the selection, how to select the RC time constant? The charging time constant is RS into C, should be short as compared to the carrier period 1 by FC. So RS into C should be very much less than 1 by FC. So the capacitor C charges rapidly. Now how to select the discharging time constant? Discharging time constant is RL into C. The RL into C value should be in between 1 by FC and 1 by W, where W is the message maximum modulating frequency. W is the message width or maximum modulating frequency. So RLC, that is the discharging time constant, should be between 1 by FC and 1 by W as shown here. Thank you.